Hello again, I'm back for round two. Man, all-star hand here. Question is what to do with it. Think again, I'll just go Forest Quirion Ranger. And now, attack for one and play Elvish Visionary. Let's hope my opponent's not playing Storm, because my hand's very well set up to beat a fair deck. All right. Okay. It's not a complete disaster. Let's start with the glimpse. Sure. Well, my opponent's done a nice job of slowing me down, but I don't mind playing from this position because it's going to take my opponent having a creature like a Tarmogoyf to even stabilize the ground. Otherwise, I can just be attacking for five. And even in that case where it becomes a stalemate, I have a lot of mana and a lot of powerful cards that I can draw into. Natural Order, Green Sun Zenith, Wyrewood Symbiote, Elvish Visionary. These Sultai decks are traditionally quite a good matchup for Elves. They got a little bit harder with the printing of Fatal Push, but still a matchup that I'm happy to play. Opponent deep in the tank here. After all that, it's no play. Note that the Arbor is not vulnerable to Wasteland because of Quirion Ranger. Sure. Right, that's what I got. Can you beat it? That's good. What to sacrifice? Yes. Well, if I sacrifice I think I'll just sacrifice the Llanowar Elves itself because that gives me the highest chance of winning if my spell resolves. Leaving the Visionary in play also allows me to draw Wyrewood Symbiote and have that be a great top deck. Well, that was cool. I just drew perfectly. Had a great opening hand and then top decked after my opponent had stabilized. So off the sideboard, I like Progenitus for this matchup. Some small number of Abrupt Decays is okay. And then I would bring in like one or two Thoughtseize if I suspected my opponent had something like Toxic Deluge. But it's hard to cut cards also. Craterhoof Behemoth, I can take one out since I'm bringing in Progenitus. And then beyond that, something like a Birch Lore Ranger, Fintorn Elves, Heritage Druid, Nettle Sentinel, Llanowar Elves. Can trim a small number of these. Maybe we'll start with minus one Birch Lore plus one Abrupt Decay and just leave it at that. Real danger of over sideboarding with elves, I think. If you're just picking up elves for the first time, you probably would do better to just not sideboard at all than to sideboard in ways that you're not sure about. I think a lot of people really damage their chances by taking out too many of the cheap creatures. After all, that's kind of the idea of the deck is almost everything has to be a cheap creature. Don't really like the idea of bringing in Thoughtseize for this matchup since it is going to come down to top decks a lot, and I don't want to have a card that does nothing when I draw it on turn 4 or 5. Abrupt Decay, while it's not necessary, it does help me when my opponent has a draw where it's like mostly disruption and just one or two creatures, and those are the draws that are actually most likely to beat me. Another really, really good hand. I'm much happier to see turn one Ponder than I would be to see turn one Deathrite, Delver, or Thoughtseize, or even just pass with a Fatal Push up. But that is a Ponder, no shuffle, so my opponent's got a hand that he or she's happy with. If it's a him, just please don't hit my cradle. Wow, dead weight. Why dead weight over disfigure? It's very strange. Disfigure is both an instant and, well, I mean, instant, both cast at instant speed and it flips the Delver. But Deadweight, I guess, is for Delirium or something like that. Okay, what to do this turn? I could Zenith for Heritage Druid. Yeah, I could just try to win this turn. Zenith for Heritage Druid. Well, it wouldn't be a win. It would be a put Progenitus into play. It seemed like my opponent didn't have Daze last turn with the Korean Ranger, so therefore I think I like that strategy. My opponent didn't have Daze last turn and then didn't flip the Delver this turn, so seems like a good idea to just go for it. Okay, see what you got. Normally, Bug Delver has very few outs to this, short of Liliana of the Veil, but you know, clearly I have a buffer for that. And then even in the worst case scenario where my opponent was to play Toxic Deluge for 10, that costs 10 life and kills both my opponent's creatures. So I'm feeling pretty good about my position here. Feel like I should probably just activate my Death Threat Shaman rather than playing another creature onto the board. I'm not going to chump block for fear of like submerged Liliana or some weird combination like that. I don't think I'm at any risk of dying. Sure. All right. One and one.